welcome everybody to another Endless Theory event.
Feel the intensity in the crowd and on the racetrack.
They're saying he's going to be the one to watch today.
All these drivers all with one goal, become the champion.
Buckle up tight, folks. Here we go. Green flag is out. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Daytona International Speedway as we continue on the Mountain Dew race weekend. Tonight, it's the Mountain Dew 400 version 1 Snickers Cup Series action ready to happen under the lights for 20 laps. I'm Seth Cole, joined by yet another co-commentator. This time, it's Randy Orton Fan 2011, a.k.a. Aaron Williams. Thanks for joining me in the booth.
Well, thank you very much for having me, Seth. I love Daytona. I love racing under the lights. And this is probably the best case scenario for me. And we got a bunch of these D1 racers, especially me, ready to go racing here under the lights.
Okay, so we're getting ready now to get the command to fire the engines. On the pole for this race, I think it's his first pole of the season, is Anthony McCrory in the number 61, Commit a Mass Murder with a Spoon. If you guys don't know what that's all about, you got to check out Silver Machine 9000's channel and his Dumb Ways to Die parody, but that's the sponsorship for his 61 today, alongside of Sophie Dillon in the 96. That's not Sophie Dillon. My fail.
That's Luke Walker.
Luke Walker in the 96. I think I'm thinking back to another series. Matt Edwards will line up in row 2 alongside of Jody Wilson in the 10, but there's a lot of big drivers at the back there that we may hear from tonight, because Daytona, as we know, it's basically not exactly where you start, it's where you finish. Anybody in this grid can win.
And like you said, you said that whenever we go to these Daytona races, they always tend to play in favor of the underdog. So we might end up seeing such a not-so-well-known name, such as, maybe Natalie Haydens or maybe Lyndon Wright come away with a good finish here. But we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Absolutely. That's definitely in the cards. As we're getting ready now to get these cars rolling off, as they roll off and complete their 2 pace laps around this racetrack, we will show you your starting grid for tonight's race. A lot of questions on whether Michael Norman could possibly end up winning a Trucks, Mobile, and Snickers Cup Series event here, just making his debut a few weeks ago. But we'll find all that out in just a moment. Alright, so we're getting ready to go under the green flag as the cars are currently in turn number 3. Kevin, we ended up seeing basically the trucks, really, there was a lot of opportunity for being able to make a pass for the lead, but in the Mobile One Cup Series, there wasn't that much of an opportunity. Drivers were not able to really get the draft to be able to move up to the back bumper of the car in front of them. What do you think tonight? What are these Snickers Cup cars going to do?
Well, these Snickers Cup Series cars are much faster than the Mobile One Cup Series cars. Of course, we always have to be careful of the big one, of course. I mean, that's the last thing we want any driver wants to see, especially a couple drivers such as Aaron Williams, Dylan Young, and Sean Henley. And here we go. We're about to take the green flag.
20 laps of racing, green in the air. And, you know, the big one is basically struck at all different ends of different races during the week. It's happened at the beginning, it's happened at the middle, it's happened at the end. What do you think tonight? Are they going to go for it early and end up causing the big one?
I would would say that they would probably go for it towards the end because... But here's one thing you also got to consider. You want to be on the inside line. After watching the truck and Nationwide series, you always want to be on the inside line, especially during the final lap, because that's the line that tends to move up the pack the most, and then that could be the beneficial factor to winning this race. As you can see, we're already going three wide as we head into turn three.
Yeah, and Anthony McCurry's going to take that spot. They're going to go three wide behind him. James McLeod, when he was in here commentating, he gave a driver's point of view of that you actually strategize where you want to be on the track the whole race, whether you want to go to the high side for a while or in the middle. What's your thoughts on that? Is that what you do when you're on the track?
For me, I would say in a race like this here at Daytona, as you just saw, Anthony McCurry lost the lead. As you saw, as in a race here at Daytona, when the inside line tends to start to get up there towards the end of the race, I would say from my point of view, you want to hang around in the back, but you don't want to stay too far back off the draft, because you lose that draft, you're going to lose a hell of a lot of positions, you're going to lose a lot of time, a lot of speed, and that could end up costing you the race. But the advantage of being in the back is that if the big one happens in front of you, you'll have plenty of time to try and get around it. Of course, you'll see all those cars go around as you just saw Ralph Mason lead a lap. But for me, I would say that you want to hang around in the back for a bit, and then right around with like two or three laps to go, you want to make your way towards the inside line and get your result towards the front.
Dylan Young now going to go to the lead there in that Hendrick car, and there are a lot of drivers up here. We saw Aaron Williams there up at front for a while. We see Ralph Mason. There's Sean Henley, Dylan Young. A lot of winners this season, but yet we do not have a two-time winner in the Snickers Cup Series. And based on how late it is in the regular season, basically if you could pick up a second win this season, you'd basically ensure yourself a spot in the chase. Would these drivers be looking at Daytona, where a lot of people consider it a mulligan track, to be able to seize that kind of an opportunity? Oh, they reckon! Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look out! Look out!
That's the big one.
Oh boy, look out.
Cars sliding everywhere.
That's one to see. Look at that, Brandon Bain, he's around. Ralph Mason led a lap. Ooh, he's going to take a hard hit from Leo Rogers right there.
Oh, wow. Devaro Broin was in it. Jake Rogers. Ricky Hawk was in it.
Didn't take long for those cars to get excited like that. And just like what you said earlier, we ended up seeing the big one early.
Is Brandon Bain involved?
Jake Rogers, he's involved. We saw all those cars stuck in the back of the pack. They really had to slow down.
Charles Sanford, I think, got a piece of it. Oh, James McLeod, Kyle Sanofsky, Luke Martin, they were all in it.
Ooh, tough break for those guys. They might have to, they're going to have some damage.
Oh, there's Lyndon Wright. He's off the pace. That Richard Childress car is crunched.
Yeah, I don't expect Lyndon Wright to finish this race. But it didn't take long before we saw that. I mean, you know, you got to consider the pressure factor for these drivers, and then one mistake by one driver ends up being the end for a bunch of others.
Bob Fergus, Sophie Dillon, they were involved, and this definitely...
Just about like the middle of the pack pretty much was involved in that.
Yeah,
almost all middle of the pack.
That started somewhere around the ninth position, I think, so that was right up at the front of the field, and the cars went up the racetrack, which is just going to involve a lot more cars. And Rhett Yates has inherited the lead now.
Good job by the rookie Rhett Yates to take over the lead as we are under the yellow flag for the first time in this race here on lap 5.
All right, we'll take a look back at a replay. We got, I'd say, a good 20 cars that got some kind of damage out of that. We're working our first caution of the night here. We are currently on lap number 5. Alright, so the first caution of the day happens up at the front of the field, and it's because they went four wide early here, which basically, it can be done, but not very often does it have a good ending.
Yep, like you said, what we saw in the Nationwide and Truck Series, when the cars go four wide, you see disaster happens. We see Leo Rogers in the 92, he goes up the racetrack, he's going to get into the 70 Ralph Mason, 17 to Kate Stewart, he's going to take a hard hit right there. Then you're going to see the 93 of Sophie Dillon go up the racetrack. They're going to get into, I would say, the 07 of Lyndon Wright. Dylan Young's going to take a hit. And then look at all these cars trying to dodge the wreck. Man.
Saw a few cars go down to the inside to miss this. I think I saw Natalie Haynes and Eric Matthews. They went down in the grass to avoid it, but track's just blocked up right here.
Yeah, especially on the outside line. The outside line just completely blocked up, especially for Aaron Williams. He was all the way towards the outside, as I saw.
Oh, Charles Samford, hard hit. Jake Rogers turned around there. And I was actually, you know, we're looking at these drivers that were involved here, and there were a few of them that were running well in points. Jake Rogers comes into this race sixth in the points, Dan, and he's caught up here in the big one.
Yeah, that's not going to be a good sign for that Penske team of Jake Rogers.
Wow, we're going to have to go on board with a few of these drivers, see just exactly what they saw. Lots of drivers involved, though.
Let's go on board, me.
All right, we're going to go on board with the 88 of Aaron Williams. Take a look what he saw. There we are, on board with the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. That's our onboard audio there with Aaron Williams, who seems to relatively get through that pretty well, but obviously not too happy. They went four wide early on. Let's go on board with another driver. All right, on board now with Eric Matthews. Watch him and Madeline Hayes miss this left. You know, I think I saw three drivers actually do a good job missing that. Natalie Hayes, Eric Matthews, and Nicole Sanchez, I think, that, or not Nicole Sanchez, but Alexandra Williams get through that. All right. On board with the Lowe's Impala. There by the 48, who by all means really should have been completely wrecked, but made it through there. We get ready to go now back to green flag action. Alright, so we're getting ready to go back under the green flag. A few drivers, though, will not be returning to this restart, and they are Bob Fergus, Lyndon Wright, Brandon Bain, and Ralph Mason. Rather surprised that only four drivers out of the race when we just had a pretty huge wreck that involved about 20 cars.
Yeah, the cars were, compared to my series, the cars weren't going as fast as you. If you ever seen my Daytona races, those cars go at 200, almost 250 miles per hour, but you're going about 180, 190 here. So it wasn't much damage going on, but as we get back to the green flag, you see Rhett Yates is your leader, and then you see Zohar Manoud, and I'm assuming Eric Burton's in the third position.
That is indeed who it is. Max Skinner lined up in fourth, and Michael Norman up here in the fifth position. So far, he's made, I think this is his sixth NNSCRA start. He has one Truck Series win that came here at Daytona. He's also got a Mobile One Cup Series win that came last week at Lowe's. This guy is making quite a name for himself right now in the NNSCRA.
I'll tell you, Michael Norman, he's definitely one of the guys to be on the lookout for in the near future. So you got to be on the lookout for him. He's definitely one of the forces to be reckoned with in this series.
Try and show you back through the top 15. Chris Dollerton is sixth. Seventh is Luke Walker. He's got some damage to that car, so I'd highly question him starting up that far to the front. William Duncan, eighth. Ninth, Arnold Columbia. Eric Matthews now 10th. Sean Henley's 11th. Matt Edwards, without his hood, is still running 12th. 13th is Garrett Williams. 14th is Felix Harris. And rounding out the top 15 is Jordan Hester.
And there you see Alex and Aaron Williams in 17th and 19th, respectively. They're still hanging up towards the back, but we're still somewhat early in this race as we get ready to go back to the green flag on lap 9.
Yeah, the pole sitter, Anthony McCurry, restarting back in the 16th position, too, so still some names there that could work their way up here to the front and win this thing, as here we go, green flag comes back out. It's on lap 9 of 20. What do you think? Do you think they've kind of said, okay, we've had our big one, now let's just race each other and not try and cause a second wreck?
think that will be a worst case scenario for a couple of drivers. Of course, you want to make your moves early, but you don't want to make them too. You want to make your moves late, but then you don't want to make them too late, and you also don't want to make your moves too early as well. I mean, you want to be in front of these guys, and like you said in the D2 race of the Mobile One Cup Series, you want to control the draft. You want to be up in front, you want to control the draft, and you can control your destiny from there. That's what you mentioned right there as we go three wide again, 3x3 for the top six.
Well, Max Skinner, he's going to go to the inside. He's winless this season, but Max Skinner, pretty much the highlight of his Snickers Cup Series season here in Season 4 is that he was the pole sitter for the Daytona 500. I think this may be the same car they actually ran the 500 when he started on the inside of the front row, so maybe tonight they can have the magic touch that will actually get them to victory lane.
Well, Mike Skinner is already going to go to the outside, and here comes William Duncan in the 91. By the way, William Duncan actually won the special contest that he won at Bristol. I don't know why he hasn't commented on that race. Sorry to make any reference to my series, but hopefully he's already noticed, and now they're going three wide again, and now Chris Dollerton with the inside advantage.
Chris Dollerton up here in the mix. I saw Eric Burton there in the middle. Seems like his car is a little loose there in the center, and that could be the fact with the, you know, the car is taking the air off the rear spoiler there, and that 49 better be careful or he'll end up spinning out right in front of this field.
Yep.
This field is kind of split up, too.
It looks like the field is, I think we have gotten the field split up now because of that big wreck. And we see they're 3x3x3, and I think that's 11 cars in that first pack, and then we saw Garrett Williams, my unrelated brother, in 12th. I'm assuming that's him. I'm not quite sure now.
That may have been him. I couldn't see that far back. You got a few drivers up here who are eligible if they pick up the win tonight to be in that wild card position. You got Sean Henley there, Arnold Columbia, our winner from Phoenix, but there are quite a few drivers up here. I think aside from those two, all these other drivers have yet to pick up a victory this season, so this could be big for them tonight, a big opportunity to capitalize.
Yeah, I think that wreck really screwed up a bunch of those drivers' chances, especially Aaron Williams and Dylan Young.
With Eric Matthews to the inside in that three car. Whoa, Arnold Columbia a little loose off that corner, nearly got turned by, I think that was Sean Henley.
I think what the second pack wants to see right now is this first pack possibly get some problems, end up wrecking each other. This way they can get that second pack back within range of the leaders, but seems that everything's going clean so far, but we'll have to wait and see as Max Skinner will lead yet another lap.
Got a total of 8 to go now. Drivers in this first pack are Max Skinner, William Duncan, Eric Matthews, Sean Henley, Zohar Mahmood, then Rhett Yates, Columbia, Eric Burton, Chris Dollerton, and then you've got Luke Walker back here along with Michael Norman. Let's take a look at the second pack, though. We see there's Alexandra Williams, Garrett Williams, Justin Acosta, Jordan Hester, and Natalie Haydens.
That's only like 5 cars. Where's everybody else?
Everybody else is way back here. There's John Castle, Sophie Dillon, Felix Harris, last week's winner, trying to catch up here. Anthony McCurry all by himself in 20th. And then there's this big pack of cars back here from about 21st on back through 29th. These guys have got to get going here. I hope these other guys up at the front are going to wreck, or else if this goes into a long green flag run, I don't possibly see how these guys are going to catch up and be able to battle for the lead.
So Aaron Williams within that pack, he's like, these guys are well off the pace for some reason. I don't know, might have been a slower car that might have ended up getting them damaged.
I think that may be the car right there, because he was up around the 12th position on that restart. I'll bet he slowed him up there on that restart.
I'll tell you, Aaron Williams might be the guy, the biggest loser out of that one. He's going to have some words with Matt Edwards after this race if he can't get back towards the front. Let's wait and see.
Another big loser could be that guy, the Blue Deuce Jake Rogers. He's the driver in this division who's running highest in the points in 6th place, and he's all the way back in 29th place, a pretty badly damaged race car. This could be something that could knock him outside of the top 10 in points, and that really would maybe hurt the chances of Jake Rogers making the chase.
Yeah, I would say that would be another one of those big losers right there, Jake Rogers. You see other cars well off the pace.
And
go back to the lead pack here. Max Skinner going to the inside. with help from Chris Dollerton and William Duncan.
You know, see a few drivers in this field of teams that have actually been doing pretty well this season. Sean Henley out of Hendrick Motorsports, at least one of every driver from Hendrick Motorsports, with the exception of Jack Richards, has been to Victory Lane this season. And then you got also Zohar Manad. I mean, really, they've kind of been under the radar, but Evan Gattuso, Tim Walsh in the past few weeks, they picked up wins for Michael Waltrip Racing. Zohar Manad running very well right now in that Aaron's Dream Machine. He could be a contender. And look at Eric Burton, one of the few single-car Dodge teams right there in that 49. He could be a factor as well.
Yeah, you got to think about this. Like, some drivers such as Max Skinner, Eric Burton, I wouldn't consider them big names, but I mean, they could finally capture their big break here at Daytona. And like you said before, Daytona tends to play a role in the favor of the underdog. So you come around with about four laps to go. At this point, if the yellow flag were to come out, then the race would be over.
Yeah, I just noticed actually, Max Skinner is 13th in the points, and with him running this well, if he could finish in the top five, we may see him next week at Chicagoland as a driver inside the top 10 in Snickers Cup Series points.
Yeah, that could definitely change. That could definitely like change the landscape of the point standings when you see, especially considering that Jake Rogers is 6th, and then you've got Max Skinner just outside the top 10.
Eric Burton to the inside of the track there, trying to block Eric Matthews making any advances. And you were talking about how it plays out to the underdog. Eric Matthews currently in points, he is way outside the top 60. Eric Matthews just about the same story. Zohar Manad just about the same for him. So a lot of drivers trying to use Daytona as their springboard to try and get their seasons turned around.
Well, that wouldn't be the case for Sean Henley, though, because he's now in the inside line, and with just about 2.5 laps to go, we'll see if maybe a veteran can pull off a big win right here, especially Sean Henley.
Yeah, Henley's actually running 32nd in points, but the interesting thing is the way that the point system is and everything. Oh, slower car, Charles
Sanford. Here we go.
Going to hold up the whole inside line, and Zohar Manad is going to go around on the outside.
That's going to give Zohar Manud and Sean Henley the advantage. Two to go now.
Manud, then Henley, then Matthews. And now they're starting to make their way by Sanford on the inside line. He's now holding up Eric Burton there.
Boy, that definitely changed the landscape of the race right there.
Boy, Henley right now, basically what Zohar Manud's got to hope is that they all remain all spaced out like that, so that way they don't catch him. But if they do start getting bunched up again, Zohar Manud is, as we say here at Restricted Plate Racing, a sitting duck.
Yes, that is true, but of course you also got to consider, if a wreck were to happen right now, the race will be over. Now Henley,
wow.
Henley quickly closing in.
He got a huge run down the back straightaway. And here it comes down to this, Henley, Manud, Eric Matthews, white flag in the air, these three may be the three to decide it.
All aboard the Viagra train, here comes Sean Henley to the inside, with help of Eric Matthews, hitting into turn one.
Chris Dollerton now lines up on the inside line. Oh, wait, the caution came out!
Oh, the yellow flag is out!
And I think Manud beat Henley to the line there!
Wait, hold on. We got to take a look who got involved. There was something... Oh, it happened in the backstretch. Happened somewhere in the backstretch. I don't know who.
Oh, I think it might have been Dylan Young and Anthony McCurry, the pole sitter.
Oh, God, tough breaks for those two big names right there.
But the question is, the white flag was out, but who was first at the stripe when the white flag waved? It was Zohar Manud.
Man, we got to take a look. If it truly is Zohar Manud, we got to take a look at that again, because that was pretty close.
I think Jake Rogers may have been involved in that wreck as well. I saw him go on the inside line there on the apron.
Yeah, again, tough break for Jake Rogers. Coming in 6th in the points, he's not going to be happy about this one.
We're going to take a look back at a replay in just a moment. We are on the white flag lap. We'll come down here to the checkers. Scoring monitor is saying it was Zohar Manad, but we're going to have to look back after we take a look at what the wreck was and see if indeed the 55 beat Henley to the line there. Boy,
yeah,
I wonder when the caution came out. I mean, where were the leaders when the caution came out?
Yeah, that's a big question. I was thinking they took the white flag and we were going to have a good run to the finish, but then all of a sudden the yellow flag came out and was like, well, that's it.
And we saw Zohar Mana basically getting freight trained on the high side. There's the checkered flag, but we're going to have to go back and see just exactly what happened and where the leaders were when that wreck occurred. Well, this was back around that third pack we were talking about when we went through the field here, and there were three Y here, but I almost think it may start with Ricky Hawk there. He's right in the back of the U.S. Army Chevrolet, and yep, there's the contact.
Right here, he has to make some contact right here. And right there, Aaron Williams just going to get clipped by Ricky Hawk. He's going to get into his teammate, Dylan Young.
Oh, McLeod, Cade Stewart get contact from that. Anthony McCurry involved.
Jason McLeod's going to take a hard hit.
Leo Rogers got a little piece of it. Oh, Sanosky got a piece of it.
Kyle Sosnowski just got right into there.
Now, we got to pause this here. We see where this wreck is, but we got to find out where the leaders were. They weren't quite to the start-finish line, and the yellow lights were on.
They weren't at the stripe just yet, but let's take a look at this. Right when I was about to say all aboard the Viagra train, the yellow flag came out right before they crossed the line.
Oh, look at Henley. He's got the drafting help from Eric Matthews. Oh my goodness.
That's just like a third of a car length right there. Zohar Manu just barely hanging on to the win over Sean Henley. But that might help out Henley in the points. But at the same time, I'm kind of wondering where Zohar Manu is in the points too. If I can take a look at the points standings. It doesn't look like he's anywhere towards the top.
No, I think Zohar Manu may be somewhere mired down around the mid-80s in points. So...
yeah.
Basically, at this point, if he's going to get into the chase, he's got to win another race and get the wild card spot. But Henley right there, it's just that much of a difference that cost Henley a chance of making the chase, because that would have been his second win of the season. And Zohar Manad, I don't think he knows how lucky he was, because he was freight trained by about five cars there in turn one, and he would have probably finished around 10th or 11th. But that caution was certainly timely for him.
True thing right there. That's a true story right there. How about we go on board a couple of cars during that big wreck? I saw myself in that one.
All right, let's go on board with Aaron Williams. Then we'll also take a look on board with the Kyle Sosnowski machine, see how he just barely got clipped. Get some more intel audio on board with the Aaron Williams machine.
I think it was Leo Rogers right there that just clipped him.
Yeah, that's a tough break there. And they see Aaron Williams just up ahead there.
Kind of lost four or five valuable points right there.
Well, we're gonna jump here with the Kyle Sosnowski machine to TV number one, because basically this race is now over. Zohar Manad is your winner. Congratulations to him, the third Michael Waltrip Racing car to go to victory lane here in season four. This will certainly help him in the point standings, but a few drivers not having that good a day that were running well in points, namely Jake Rogers. He was sixth in points and not a good points day for him, but on the flip side, Max Skinner, a good run for him. He may be inside the top 10 in the points heading into Chicagoland. But we've got more action coming your way. Two more divisions of Snickers Cup Series Racing are just on the horizon. Kevin, thanks for joining me here today, and I know you're going to be around for the other two races, so looking forward to that.
All right, thank you very much, Seth. I mean, despite a very disappointing finish in the bottom 10, I mean, I still had fun co-commentating this race, gave me in-car audio of mine. I'll still got to get used to the D2, and I'm kind of used to the D3, but I still got to get used to the D2 rosters. But hey, I'll be here all weekend. I'll be able to sign autographs, so make sure you stay tuned, guys.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to like this race if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to become a part of the crew today. And you've been watching a production of the NSRA Offline Racing That's Best. Here comes the official finishing results.
Oh yeah, and subscribe to the gang too.
That's right, subscribe to Randy Orton Fan 2011 as well.